Hello and welcome to the second part of Busso's design fix. Today we're going to look at the fixes of the shortcomings that I identified in the review. If you see my review, you'll know that I love the top half of this car, but the bottom half and some of the features I didn't like so much. So I've made a render of this car and been applying some of the fixes to it. So let's have a look. I'll be using the render to fix three parts of this car. First, the front. Second, those awkward door handles. And third, in the next video, I'll be touching on the rear. So let's start with that front end. Essentially, they've put in a lot of shapes in all sorts of directions to hide the height of the car. I think the outcome is pretty messy, and actually with the result of it looking even taller than it should. The good news though, is that Lamborghini already has a few solutions in-house. The easiest way of masking this issue is to have that trim painted black, so you don't see it as much. And while making this render, Lamborghini actually launched the Performante version, which has more horizontal features, making it look less tall. It's like picking the right shirt for your size. If you're tall and slim already, don't wear vertical stripes. The last option would be what they've done with the concept car, and that's pitching that nose down. It looks way better. But I won't be taking that option into account, because I guess the space will be needed. Over to my render then. So, here it is. What I've done here is first of all take out those Y shapes at the sides, which make it look so cluttered. Secondly, I've made it look lower by lowering that horizontal lip and swapping it with the license plate holder. Third, the bar with the license plate holder is now going from side to side, adding another horizontal line to the design. And lastly, I filled up the void that appears then at the bottom after taking away that ridiculous spoiler. Of course, I applied a hexagon shape that Lamborghini likes so much and gave a little kink in it to refer back to the line in the hood. As for the end result, I think it looks much cleaner, much broader, equally aggressive, and still has that nice sharp beak when you look at it from the side. Next up, those awful door handles. They look like they come straight from an Audi without any design work put into it. Worse still, that rear one is positioned on the hip where it catches the eye in almost any light. There are plenty of examples out there of how it can be done with just a little bit more effort. The most modern and sleek way of incorporating door handles is what you see on the electric and hybrid cars nowadays. Unfortunately, this does require more advanced electronics, so won't be an option for this car. Second option would be to incorporate it into the lines of the car, which you see quite often. I think it works really well, but it will never work with this car because of where the line ends and goes over into the shoulder line. Placing a door handle there would make things even worse. What you can also see here is that you can actually put a little design into the door handle, as Mercedes have done with this line passing through it. Surely, Lamborghini could have made theirs more hexagonical-ish, if that's a word. Another option would have been is integrate the door handle next to the rear window. However, this car has frameless windows, so you can't put a handle there. So I went back shopping in the Volkswagen warehouse and found these. They're the latest variant of these old floppy door handles. I have to say they look pretty good now, although probably they won't feel as sturdy as the traditional ones. In this version of Volkswagen, you don't actually open them up by pulling them out, you compress them on the inside to open the door. So here we have the render with the Volkswagen style door handles, and I think they look pretty good. I used the hexagon shapes obviously to match the design language of Lamborghini, and the only drawback I would say is that they appear to be a bit too low because the eye gets drawn to the cutout rather than the shape overall. Perhaps we could rotate them and make them vertical, but I guess that will take out a bit of the dynamic. And you've probably spotted it already in the first view of my render. I've also played with these embedded door handles. So if Lamborghini ever upgrades the electrical system of this car, this may very well be an option. Besides hexagons, Lamborghini also seem to love Y shapes, as we've seen them in the front in the original version. So I also gave it a shot to make a Y shape in the door handles, but they turned out to look more like rocket ships than anything else. Next time, we'll be looking into that rear end. As you may have seen in my review, I think it's way too flat below the lights. It's too much utility vehicle, too little supercar. So let's see if we can get some supercar DNA from these other Lamborghini designs into this SUV. I hope you liked my fixes to the front and to these awful door handles. And keen to read any ideas you may have in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and hope to see you again soon.